So this morning we met with members of the First Nation. Very exciting, very useful information shared with elders, traditional land users and youth on which animal species we should monitor, where we should do it, and when we should do it.
This is where working with the community members, getting help and answering, you know, what should we be looking at? When should we be sampling it? Where should we go? I mean, I don't know. I've never lived here, but the elders and the traditional knowledge that's been passed down for generations and generations, it's so important in helping us identify, you know, what we should be looking at. They know a lot. These are observations, you know, that have been acquired over centuries.
Water quality, when I was growing up in Fort Chip, I used to get water from down the hill. So we haul water up and we drink the water. There's nothing wrong with the water. That was back in 1960. Back then you could pretty well drink from any creek or any stream.
Every fall I go out there and trap the muskrats. This year I trapped out there, fine fur I got. Yeah, two muskrats, that's what I got this fall. That's the worst I ever done in the 50 years plus I have trapped.
That's our, the way we make our living. Muskrats. We're trapping. There's no muskrats, no trapping.
2 years now, we're losing moose. Where's it gone? Where's it gone to?
I see people, they're very sad, especially the hunters and that. They're really sad because it's part of their life of living off the land and able to get out there and bring in food for the families.
So it all boils down to water. Water is the boss. And without water, mud animals are not around. Most of them move away, most of them die out.
It's getting to be too late now. We've got to act now. 17 years from now, what's going to happen?
We talked about the importance of integrating our program. So essentially looking at not only the health of the animals, but what the animals are eating and what they're drinking and what they're living in order to get a better sense of any impact and any sources and sinks where we might want to focus our efforts moving forwards.
What could be done? What changes could be made for the better of the health of the environment? You just need to get the ball rolling. And as time goes on, things works out.
Follow along in part 3 as Phil Thomas investigates the health of the local ecosystem by getting his hands dirty dissecting river otters with youth and elders of the Mikisew Cree and Athabasca Chipewyan First Nation. This video series was made possible through funding from the Oil Sands Monitoring Program and was produced in collaboration with the Mikisew Cree and Athabasca Chipewyan First Nations.